Alright, today I'm going to be showing you how to make homemade thermal grease or thermal paste using household items. Now, this is primarily used for testing. If you absolutely, positively do not have thermal grease, I only recommend this as a temporary solution. Now, this idea came from Tom's Hardware from many, many years ago, so it's something I wanted to test to see how it works. It's primarily used in third world countries like Ghana and in Sakawa to get old boards or broken boards up and running again so they can use them online. For this tutorial, you will need something to mix it in, some vegetable oil or olive oil, some white toothpaste. I do not recommend the gel paste or anything that's colored. Now, based on what I've read, it's supposed to be kind of a 50-50 mixture, and we don't need a lot, but I'm gonna make a good glob here, that way everybody can see it. Basically, the toothpaste is used to thicken it up. The oil is used to keep it wet. And make sure you mix it really, really well. Otherwise, it's going to get runny and it's just going to go onto the motherboard. Now, if you look at the ingredients of the toothpaste, there is some water in there. So you do need to be careful. The oil is anti-static. Let's put our original mixture back on the CPU. Put a good glob on there. Start normally. Now keep in mind, this is a standard 775 heat sink and fan with the mixture of toothpaste and olive oil. We were able to use toothpaste and olive oil to create thermal grease because it is working, it is on, we're not getting overheating issues, and the computer is actually functioning pretty normally. Now, I'll go ahead and zoom in on the screen here so you can see the temperatures. They're not great, but they're not bad either. Okay, so as we can see, the temperatures of the diodes versus the internal. I mean, the internal and temperature is what you really want to look at. Well, it's 40 Celsius and it's 104 degrees Fahrenheit, which isn't too bad. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please ask them below. And have a great one.